neurologist
about 15 years ago, who was on my show on another station in another lifetime, who I regard as the foremost psychic in America and perhaps in the world. And he told some people some interesting, accurate things. And we are pleased to have him back with us again today to answer your questions and talk to you. He is his name is the Amazing William, and William is from Newcastle, Indiana. You have seen him on every radio talk show, every television talk show, from Sally Jesse to you name it. Amazing and confounding people, and he goes all over the country doing this. And William, it has been a long, long time. How are you doing?
Well, I'm doing very, very nicely, thank you, and thanks for having me here today.
You know, it has been 15 years, and that's fair.
Yes, it has. That's been a long time.
That's hard to realize.
But it will not be 15 years again.
I hope not.
It will be.
Oh, you're making
as a matter of fact, it will be 9 months.
Really?
And I'll be back, yes, 9 months from today.
All right. Well, I got to go ahead and put that on the calendar, can I?
You pretty much can.
All right. As a matter of fact, I guess the last time I saw you, when we were both doing speeches in Fort Wayne at a seminar up there. And
that's right.
4 or 5 years ago.
Yes.
So
yes.
In any event, we are delighted to have you back. We're going to take some calls. So we'll ask folks that are on hold already, just to please be patient. We're going to take some calls. But I want to get a little background. Because as I recall, the last time we talked, we just kind of talked in generalities about what you were going to do that day. Mm-hmm. You are a native of Newcastle, Indiana.
That's correct. Born on a farm there.
At about what age did you realize that you suspect that you might have some abilities that other people don't have?
Well, interestingly enough, I would say that probably, I know exactly. At the age of 10, I had an accident. I fell off a pony and was knocked unconscious. And during that time, something happened in my life, and something happened inside me during that time of unconsciousness. And when I awoke, I was in the hospital. And I saw my mother, and I said, "Mama, don't worry, because I'll be going home on Tuesday." And she said, "How do you know that?" And I said, "I just know."
You described to me the last time we talked this being like you had read a book about the person or persons that you were. And this all happens in a twinkling.
That's right.
And sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. You're the first one to admit this.
Certainly, it's not. No psychic or no one who claims psychic power can say that they are 100% or any percentage, really. It just depends. There are days when my accuracy is very high, and there are other days when it slips a little bit.
Yeah.
Because of, I don't know, because of the atmosphere, because of me, because of lack of sleep, a number of things that can play into that.
What do you think about and I hesitate to call them your colleagues, about the psychics we see in the Star and the Inquirer, and they're forecasting a year ahead, and they're mm-hmm. saying things like Prince Philip is going to abdicate and become a major league polo player.
Yeah.
And they do these all for a year. And what do you think about those folks?
Well,
be candid.
Most of them are complete phonies. They're fakes. They are doing this. They're doing it on a very commercial level. First of all, they're being paid for it, and it becomes a kind of an entertainment thing. They make all these predictions about people they don't know that they've but yet the people they make predictions about are always those people who are
headliners,
right?
Yeah.
In the public eye, and it's titillating for people to look at what's going to happen. How long are we going to make predictions about Liz Taylor and Jackie O and the same people?
Don't forget Cher.
20 years they've been doing that, and for 20 years most of them have been wrong about nearly everything.
All right. Well, we have a lot of folks who want to talk to you today. I hope you're in tune. Are you ready to take some telephone calls?
Certainly, and I do feel very, very much in tune, as a matter of fact.
Our first caller is Walt on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Walt.
Ludlow.
How are you?
Good morning.
I'm not quite sure how this works.
Well, let me just tell you how it works, Walt. By the sound of your voice is the way this works. That's what tunes in. What you need to do is just ask him a question, and he may have a few questions for you, and be prepared to be amazed, Walt.
All right, this is kind of a long story.
Okay, go right ahead.
My wife's grandmother recently passed away, and somehow she ended up with her house. We're out here next to Grant Park at one of these giant, rambling, Victorian-type houses, and rumor has it from my wife's childhood that her grandmother is somewhat of a pack rat. That's understatement. But she's also supposedly very wealthy. But after her death, her bank account showed she had very, very little money. And like I said, rumor had it when my wife was a little girl that she used to hide money and jewelry everywhere all over the house. And this house is about 5,500 square feet.
You've been having a treasure hunt, hadn't you, Walt?
Pretty much. And we're just trying to find out if there's anything here.
Walt, let me be sure that I'm tuned in to you. This home is a two-story home and has dormers on the front. Is that correct?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Now, I don't know why, but this home has been painted within the last 2 or 3 years and painted blue. Is that correct?
I painted it myself.
Yeah, it's blue. It is
blue.
Kind of a Robin Jig. Okay.
That's incredible.
Now, Walt, I don't know why, but I have the feeling that you're in a downstairs room, which might have been at one time called perhaps, it's not like a big living room, but like a sitting room, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. There's a fireplace there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's a shallow fireplace, one of those that was used to burn coal rather than wood. Is that?
That's right.
Okay.
The little insert is still in there.
I keep focusing on this fireplace. There's a table in front of the fireplace now. It's unused, the fireplace. While you still are on the phone, can you get walk over to that fireplace?
Sure. Mm-hmm. Let me get this stuff out of the way.
And pull that table aside, Walt. Pull that table aside. Walt, there is a little metal.
There's moving furniture.
There is a little metal insert in there. If you will reach your hand up into the flue,
okay,
you'll feel a piece of metal there that's blocking the flue.
Mm-hmm.
Can you wrap your fingers around the edge of that and just give a little tug on it?
I've got it.
Uh huh.
A little box.
That's what. Yeah. It's a little metal box, gray. Mm-hmm.
Well,
just flip that latch.
Don't leave us here. Open the box.
Flip the latch.
Drop the phone. Okay, go ahead. Use both hands on the box if you need to. We'll hold. It's incredible.
What did you find, Walt?
Well, a lot of cash.
Really? Mm-hmm. Walt, I don't want to pry into your purse, but about how much, Will?
I don't know.
Those are probably mostly 50s, 100s.
Well, I don't know. It's just in a big pile.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Walt, what do you think, Walt? What's your, I know, emotionally, outside the money, what do you think right now?
Is there any more? Well,
One of the things that I'd like you to do, Walt, is check the other fireplaces in the house. I know there are three other fireplaces downstairs, and they all have been, all of the flues have been blocked off. And I would suggest to you that that you pull those little pieces of metal out. I think you'll find
What do you think, Walt?
This is great.
Take care, buddy.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye. An incredible demonstration.
Thank you.
An incredible demonstration. More calls after this.
This is Scott Slade.
All right, welcome back, gang. 7 minutes after 10 o'clock at AM 750 WSB, 82 degrees. Our special guest is the amazing William, and amazing he has been today. Your accuracy rating is way, way up there. You're up there close to Mandrake the Magician. You're right there today.
It has been. A lot of good things, a lot of good feelings have come. But it comes and goes, very quickly.
All right, well, I certainly hope it does not leave you on a 50,000-watt clear channel radio show.
Yes, it certainly helps.
82 degrees. You ready to go back to work, would you?
Certainly.
All right, we're going to talk to Michelle on AM 750 WSB. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, good morning.
How you doing, my friend?
Oh, pretty good. I just have a humorous source of aggravation.
Okay.
I can't find the remote control to my television set.
Boy, yeah, that's awful. We lost ours one time. You know what happened? Our youngest had it walking around and gone to the refrigerator to get some milk and left it in the refrigerator. We almost never found it.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
But I was wanting to know if the man could help me out.
Yeah. William, any advice?
Michelle, are you married?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Your husband's at work.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's in his car.
It's in his car?
Yeah.
Or his truck?
Oh, it's a vehicle. I'm not sure. Oh, you're right. It's in the truck.
It's in the truck?
Yeah. Somehow, it was in a... I think it... This is going into the past, and it's very difficult for me. But it seems as though he had it in a shirt pocket or some such thing. And it fell out of the shirt pocket is the only thing I can figure. Or a jacket pocket, perhaps. He took the jacket off. Would that make sense? Does he wear a jacket in his work? Or
A shirt. He takes extra shirts to work.
Ah, okay. That's what it was then, yeah.
Oh, so it's in the...
Look in the truck.
I'll have to call him and make him go look.
Call
he's going to accuse me. Okay.
Yeah, I'll call him and tell him to look down along the... on the passenger side. Down beside the sea.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 872-0750. It's in the truck. 82 degrees. Let's talk to Arlene on AM 750 WSB. Hello, sweet Arlene.
Hey.
How you doing?
I'm fine, thanks. I have a question for William.
Okay, it's the amazing William.
Good morning.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. Yeah, you can just call him Z. That's what I do.
Okay. Sounds good.
Go right ahead.
My sister passed away a couple of years ago. The night before she died, she had some rings, and they disappeared.
Mm.
And I was wondering if he could help me with that.
Arlene, I'm trying to focus, and I cannot, I just, nothing is coming through. This was a couple of years ago?
Yes.
Yeah. My dear, I...
She had put them away somewhere in her house, mm-hmm. and she never found them.
I wish I could help you, but this is just one of those where there's some kind of blockage that's stopping me from... I see nothing.
We wish you luck, Arlene.
Thank you.
Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Welcome back, gang. It is 10:36 at AM 750 WSB. Ludlow Porch and the amazing William. Let me ask you a question, Thee. I noticed that any time I punch up a telephone call, what are you doing when I do that?
I'm just feeling jolts. The vibrations are so strong. I think it has something to do with the atmospheric conditions and the fact that there's high humidity and high temperature. But I'm feeling jolts of things, as you notice, and I apologize for that, but I really am feeling jolts of things, and they seem to be very accurate today. Most of the callers that we've had...
You knew that one caller was wearing a blue dress. That's pretty...
Yeah, that really just hit me.
Yeah.
Just hit me.
All right, let's take some more calls. Mm-hmm. Let's get back to the phones and talk to Sheila on AM 750 WSB. Hello, lovely Sheila.
Hello, how are you?
I'm great. How you doing?
Doing just fine, thank you.
Good.
I have a question. My husband and I are building a home in South Georgia.
Brick.
No, it's wood.
Right.
It's on piling.
Oh, yeah, I see. Mm-hmm.
And we had planned on moving down in a few years. In the meantime, a large company had requested my resume.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wondering how that was going to work out.
Three bedrooms?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You've had some problems with the plumbing there, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know why, but pipes just all of a sudden flashed in front of my face.
Mm-hmm.
As far as this resume is concerned, nothing ventured, nothing gained, nothing lost.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and send them the resume, you know, hold on to your dream. Hold on to your dream.
Mm-hmm.
Faces to the west.
The house faces the west?
I guess.
Yeah. As you look out that big window.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That would be out the west.
Good luck to you.
Mm-hmm.
Take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
872-0750.
They're just hitting me. They're just hitting me.
Oh, yeah. Let's talk to Lisa.
Yes.
Hello, Lisa. How you doing, you rascal?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Good.
I have a couple of questions.
Lisa, why do I get the word railroad?
Railroad?
Yeah. Is there anything, any connection there?
No.
Okay.
Not that I know of.
Just a false, a false message, I suppose. Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
Okay. You're actually not supposed to be calling me right now.
Why is that?
Oh, I just get the feeling that there's something else you're supposed to be doing.
Working.
Uh-huh. That's what I thought. You're calling me on work time. Mm-hmm.
They know, though.
Well, good for you.
Okay.
Well, that's wonderful. If you got an employer that lets you call, we love it.
That's right.
You want to plug them? What do they do? Is it a legal thing?
Printing.
Okay. You can give the name if you want to.
Print Crafters.
All right. Now, what's your question?
I just wondered if there's going to be any significant changes in my life in the next year.
Yes.
Can you tell me what?
No.
How about that?
No, I don't want that answer.
Are these good changes?
One has to do with your weight.
With my weight?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Are you... There's going to be a tremendous event in your life. Some kind of an event.
You know when?
Has to do with the physical. In the next few months.
Huh.
Am I
any
right?
Any of that make any sense?
Well, I was wondering if I might be pregnant.
I am not a physician. I can't say for sure.
What do you think, Lisa?
I think yes.
Go with that feeling.
Okay.
What do you mean, go with that feeling? She'll damn well have to go with that.
You can't tell me, like...
No, I cannot. Oh. Nor would I.
Okay.
Well, listen, I'm happy for you, Lisa.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see any problems?
No, I don't.
If it's a girl, I want you to promise me that you'll name it Ludleen because you heard it here
first. Well, of course.
Or William. Boy.
Or just amazing.
William Ludleen would be a lovely name.
Yes.
Don't do that to the child.
Is there any way you could tell something about a good friend of mine?
That's usually very, very difficult.
Oh, take a shot.
Sure.
He has an important interview in a couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see?
The only thing that I would advise you to tell him is one thing not to do, and that is not to mention Houston.
Okay.
Sam or Texas?
Houston, Texas. Not to mention the connection, the Houston connection.
Okay.
Does that make, does that ring a bell with you?
Not really, but it might with him.
It might with him. I think it will, but as I say, this is kind of a connection thing here, and you know, we're talking about you and your friend, and all I can get are the vibrations about your friend that you transmit, and that makes it, that does make it somewhat difficult.
Do you see any health problems in my immediate family?
No, I don't. Other than one nervous problem, but it's a minor one.
Okay.
It could be picking up me. I'm pretty nervous.
Okay. Well,
take care of your sweet self.
Thank you. I'll bring Ludleen to see you.
Do that and go outside and print something now. You've used up all this company money.
I sure will.
We appreciate it.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 872-0750 is our number. And I want to remind all you Bell South Mobility customers out there, you can call all of our talk shows absolutely free, 872-0750. And if you're fortunate enough to be a Bell South Mobility customer, it is on the house.
One of them is calling now.
Yes, exactly right. It is exactly right. Let's go talk to Roger on AM 750 WSB. What do you say, Roger?
Good morning.
How you doing?
Just fine.
Good. You're on the air, Roger.
Thank you.
Go ahead. Talk
go
to
ahead.
You.
Well,
go ahead.
Need to turn your radio down, Roger.
General Motors? Does General Motors mean anything to you, Roger?
No.
Doesn't mean anything to me either.
I let my car run hot. I bet the belt broke on it.
It's a General Motors car.
No, it's a Ford.
No, it's a Ford. That's right.
And I changed the belts on it, and it still runs hot.
Mm-hmm. I would say take it to a mechanic.
That's where I was going to when I got off the air.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't know if it was going to be serious or just a minor.
No, I think it's a thermostat. Stuck.
That's what my brother-in-law told me.
Yeah.
Your brother-in-law a psychic?
No.
Well, I am, and I can tell you that it sounds to me like a stuck thermostat.
Okay.
That's what I'm feeling in the engine, is have them look at the thermostat first.
Okay.
And then have them look at the water pump.
I had three belts on it,
mm-hmm.
two of them on the same pulley. I replaced those, and the other belt that I had was too short, so I'm going to have to exchange it. But I put the other one back on, and the air conditioner is squealing, or the belt's squealing. But
yeah. Don't run the air conditioner on the way to the mechanic.
Okay. So you'd think it'll be more or less minor, or...
Just keep your windows rolled down, and don't run the air conditioner, and don't honk the horn.
Ed, always listen to your brother. 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK, Ludlow Porch, and the one and only Amazing William. And we're going to talk to Lori on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Lori.
Hey, how you doing today?
Doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing real good.
There's something wrong with your telephone.
There is?
Mm-hmm. When you finish this call, you need to unscrew that little... the little mouthpiece thing, and take out the little gizmo that's inside there, and just dust it off. Take a little dry brush or something like that and dust it off, and then put it back together.
Okay, I'll do that. The question I have for you is
a little home maintenance tip, there, Lori.
I'll get right to it.
All right.
My mother is not deceased, but she has willed me the wedding ring that she was married in, and it was either a white gold or a silver band, and I wore it, and I misplaced it or lost it.
Ooh, did you tell Mama yet?
No, I haven't.
Good for you. Never, ever tell her.
Don't ever tell her.
I don't think I will.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
No clues, Lori?
The only thing I can figure is that I've worn it, and it slipped off my finger because it didn't. It didn't exactly fit, and I had been wearing it behind another ring that I was wearing.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's awful. That's tough.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is. I'm very sad to hear that, but I don't know where it is. I'm very sorry because are you calling from upstairs?
Yeah, I'm on the second floor.
Right. Yeah. So I do have the right one, and No, I don't see it. I'm sorry, Lori.
Okay, that's kind of what I thought, too.
Mm-hmm.
Wish you luck, my friend.
Thanks.
I hope you just stumble across this.
I do, too.
Okay, I've had it happen twice in my life. People who have lost rings thought they were gone forever and found them.
Okay.
So we wish you luck.
Thanks a lot. Mm-hmm.
Take care of your sweet self. Talk to you.
Thanks. Yeah. Bye-bye.
And say hello to Jerry.
Anybody else you should say hello to?
Oh, yeah, Frank.
Jerry and Frank. Should be tickled with that.
Okay, here's what's happening this week on AM 750 WSB.
The home of booger music right here.
Dreyfus.
Yes, you're exactly right. Jack Dreyfus. He is here visiting with us, and we are delighted to have you. And I understand, Jack, that you've been listening to WSB since Eisenhower was a corporal. Is that right? Welcome, my friend. We hope you enjoy yourself. Thank you for coming by. The Amazing William is on duty, 872-0750. We're going to talk to Mark on AM 750 WSB. What do you say, Mark?
Hey, Ludley, how you doing today?
Doing great. How you doing?
Well, all right. Listen, I got a couple little quickies here for you. I recently relocated from another state and trying to make a better future for the son I had to leave behind.
Yeah.
I'm taking, matter of fact, the second time I'm going to retake this test. And it's a state exam, actually. And, well, nervous about it, to say the least. Just trying to get an idea on that.
Don't do what you did last time, the night before the test.
Uh-huh.
You remember what you did the night before the test.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's why you failed it.
Pretty much.
That's right.
Okay.
But don't do that, you'll be okay.
One other little quickie, if I could. Got a potential legal problem since I moved down here. Had one job and got a problem with that particular employer that I'm probably going to be taking legal action on.
Uh-huh.
Anything running on that.
Uh-huh. You happy with your lawyer?
Haven't really isolated on one right yet.
Oh, I see.
Got a couple of people. I got a good lawyer in Colorado where I'm from.
Yeah, don't use him.
Okay, I'm just, like I said, I've got isolated to a couple of people right here. One's mm-hmm. on vacation right now, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. Talk with him some more when he gets back off of vacation. I think you'll like him.
Sounds good.
Take care of yourself.
All right, take care, guys.
Good to talk to you.
Bye-bye.
By the way, Ludlow, this is a message for Jack Barton. Do not buy the power hedge trimmer.
Jack for Jack Barton?
Right, do not. I know Jack is listening. I know that. No need to call Jack, but don't buy the power hedge trimmer.
And you just pull that out of the air?
These things happen.
Why should he not? We've got warranty problems. What's the problem?
There's a power problem. There's a short problem in his at his house.
He can't reach the top of the hedge, is that?
He'll shock himself.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Any other predictions?
Yes, Eddie, go ahead and marry the girl, as you promised you would.
Yeah, and, Eddie, do the honorable thing, Eddie.
And move to South Dakota.
Because her daddy will kill you.
That's correct. Yeah. That's correct. Pay no attention to what your sister says about that. Do it, Eddie.
All right.
Do it.
All right. Anyway, anybody could reach you?
No.
After you leave here?
No.
Anybody come to see you and get a private reading?
No.
No, you don't. You don't want to be involved in that at all?
I do not. No, I do not do this. You must understand, I do not do this for gain or profit.
Why do you do it, William?
I do it because I have the gift.
Okay, but you never give private readings.
I do not give private readings, nor do I solicit people to come to an office or any such thing as that. I have my own independent method of supporting myself.
How do you do that?
I can't say on the air.
Okay. Do you ever set any albums out of the trunk of your car, anything like that?
I have my own investments. I have investments.
Well, you've truly been amazing.
Yes.
And
you will enjoy Switzerland.
Okay. Yeah, very good. Very good. I love it. The Amazing William. Well, listen, will you come back to see us?
Certainly. I would be happy to. I enjoy this very much.
It's always a delight to have you here, and you are truly amazing.
Amazing.
The Amazing William. All right, we're going to open it up after the news. Stick around and enjoy the news, and then we're going to have some exciting two-way conversation on AM 750 WSB.
Goodbye, Mary.